कैसे हो कैसे हो कैसे हो कैसे हो। तो आ गया हूँ मैं फिर से आज। आई वॉज ग्रूविंग ऑन वन सॉन्ग, सो आई थॉट बहुत दिन बाद मैं सुन रहा था गाना, ये मैंने सोचा चलो आज वाई नॉट डू समथिंग डिफरेंट, सम डिफरेंट सॉन्ग विच आई पर्सनली ऑल्सो आई रियली लाइक दैट सॉन्ग। I was just listening, I was just listening songs on YouTube and I thought why not do open session of that particular song. So guess what could be today's song? Okay, let me just play it only to you. By the way, कैसे हो? How are you guys? मेरी साउंड फैमिली का क्या हाल चाल है? सब लोग ठीक ठाक है? सबको हेलो नमस्ते एवरीबडी, हेलो नमस्कार मंडी, इवाला मी कोसम ए सरप्राइज तीसुकोच्चानु। सो टुडे एक्चुअली ओके, जस्ट लिसन टू द सॉन्ग देन आई टेल यू फर्दर व्हाट आई वांट टू एक्सप्लेन। ओके नो इट डिडंट प्ले।
केमिन केम कावले चाले इति चाले इके नुवे वोची वाला रे इकपे तेरा नाले
सो बाय नाउ यू नो, सो दिस इज़ अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल ट्रैक। द नेम इज इंकेम इंकेम, इट्स देयर ऑन यूट्यूब, गो एंड चेक इट आउट। आई मिक्स्ड आई थिंक मे बी 2 years अगो। ब्यूटिफुल सॉन्ग बाय गोपी सुंदर, अमेजिंगली डन, ब्यूटिफुल। इट्स इट्स वन ऑफ द यू नो इट्स there are so many songs which you feel really happy to work on. Actually almost all the songs I get like that only, where I feel very happy to work on, but some songs are very special. So this song is also very special for me because it had if you listen to the song, it has a beautiful love feeling, very amazing love feeling. Pyar ka ek bahut acha feel hai is gaane mein. टुडे आई थॉट चलो ठीक है, वाई नॉट इंकेम इंकेम, इट्स अ तेलुगु सॉन्ग, गो एंड लिसन टू इट ऑन यूट्यूब। मूवी नेम इज़ गीता गोविंदम। सो आई विल कम बैक, लेट्स गो बैक टू माई लॉजिक स्क्रीन एंड लेट्स सी विदाउट मच वेस्टिंग टाइम। सो आई जम्प्ड इन टू माई स्क्रीन ऑफ द सेशन। सो एज यू कैन सी सेशन इज अगेन सेम थिंग, ब्यूटिफुली अरेंज्ड। अभिषेक हमेशा ये देखो कितने अच्छे से, वेरी नाइसली इज कलर्ड एंड क्लीनड अप एवरीथिंग। इट्स माई फर्स्ट रूल। हियर वी हैव द सेशन ओवर हियर। ऑन द साइड आई इम्पोर्टेड स्टेम्प्स विच आई, और मे बी वेव फाइल, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इट इज। दीज आर द फाइल्स विच आई रिसीव फॉर मिक्सिंग। सो लेट मी टेल यू वन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग, दैट इन दिस सॉन्ग ऑल्सो दस almost everything is live except couple of rhythm tracks. Other than that everything is live. I'll come one by one to the track. First I'll play you how this song was when I received it and what I thought. I'll just play you this, hear this, and then we'll go back to the mixed one and I'll tell you what's you can hear the difference by yourself, you can listen to it, but I'll explain you how I got that difference from here to there. So let's listen to the wave files which I received, which is So this is basically unmixed version. Let's go to let me turn on my master plugins so that I can play you everything with the master and mix. And this is now the mix and master version.
ఆనందం kavale chale idi chale ikai nuve vachi valave ikapai tiranaale
undellona vegam penchave kumbam loki
so sorry I'm in like good mood today. आज मैंने बहुत सारा काम ख़त्म किया. सेम रात अर्ली मॉर्निंग होने वाला है, ऑलमोस्ट मॉर्निंग होने वाला है. तो आई थॉट चलो आई फिनिश माई वर्क टुडे, लेट्स मेक द वीडियो ऑफ इनके मिंके एंड नाउ विल गो वन बाय वन अगेन फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट. व्हाट ट्रैक्स आर देयर इन दिस एंड व्हाट लेयर्स वेर देयर एंड देन व्हाट डिड आई डू. सो यू हर्ड द डिफरेंस, यू नो इट्स If I just play you quickly, you can hear it. Now. So how it is sounding so round and so large space again, reverb, don't underestimate the power of reverb. I'll come back again to this because why I'm opening certain songs, mostly main songs which has lot of reverb. I'll open other dry ones also one by one. So I'm just doing it like, you know, first to make you guys understand that how can you, you know, play with reverb and take songs from one place to other place. At the same time, next when the next videos which I make, I'm going to open the sessions where there are very less reverb, where it's not heard much but yet it's doing the job. So how can you go from that lushy big to a different space altogether? So this is these are the trick for you know, reverbs, basically edit of the reverbs and selection of the reverb. Same reverb you can use, and you can just edit the reverb in a way where it sounds big and large. So let's come over here how it sounds so large and big after the mix and master. So I'll just you know, enlarge the screen so that you can see it nicely. So this is kick. I'll actually keep adding one layer so you'll understand you know what's happening. This is kick, which has some kind of, you know, 8-bit processing happening. Snare, shakers, bass line, yes, see, less is more. So you can see how many tracks are there, but yet the song sounds very big and massive. So if we have less instrument, definitely we have more space to fit in multiple things inside the mix. And you can see there's a layer of kick, snare, one high perk, there's bass guitar, and rest all the chord work live guitar is doing. This is all live guitar and some live instruments. So now if I add chorus,
uhala kudora kani sogasa upirini vadalani golusa.
Why I'm playing this song more, because maybe a lot of people don't know, since it's a Telugu song, though this song was you know, quite popular everywhere in almost all the places. It's one of the most popular song of this film called Geeta Govindam. So see, there are some bypass plugins over there. So I'll come back from the start. So basically, same thing, you know, auxes, every instrument has is going to respective buses. You can see this is the instrument and the right hand side, this is the bus of that. So kick is going to kick, snare, shaker, hi-puck going to hi-puck, then bass bus, then guitars and respective buses. It's like next, vocal goes to vocal, chorus goes to chorus. So this bus technique I've been showing since the, you know, first open session. So I'll come over here and start from the groove that what did I do? You can see I've used very less plugin, but still what happened in this less plugin that it sounds so large. So when we come over here, this kick is going on. I did some processing, maybe later on I didn't like it, so I just bypassed it. Then we have snare. Now in snare, there's a very slight 0.5, you know, decibel cut around 4.7. It's a very wide cue to give the snare slightly softer approach, you know, like cutting, basically chopping off that mid attack from the snare. And then hi-puck. This hi-puck compression is sidechained to kick track. I use a lot of sidechain again in this song just to have that air of kick moving when everything comes in. Then there is bass, there's guitars, I'll show you. So there's one guitar, the layer is chord basically. I'll mute the vocals for now so that it's much more easier to understand what was done in the track, because it's very important to understand actually what was done, since you guys can't see much plugins over here, but what it is doing. So why I didn't process and then you see the groove is going back to a bus call all rhythms. So everything you play. Hi-puck. So you can see there's only one small high-mid cut, half decibels, and there's nothing else happening in the groove in terms of processing, but that processing is happening on the master. So I concentrated on the overall sound for this track, because we had very less layers, very less instrument happening in this entire song. So I got more, you know, you don't, if there's very clean and less tracks happening, you have more space to breathe in, so you don't have to cut in more and you don't have to increase much to make it large. You can sum it and take everything on a bus, and you can process the entire bus to give it one sound basically. So this is what I've done with the guitar over here. What I've done with guitars is all the guitars are coming to one bus. There's a processing on the channel as well, I'll show you. I'll start from the channel actually. Something I didn't like, I bypassed, maybe I would have added some reverb, didn't like, removed. Here's some processing going on in a channel where, what is this? So it's a tremolo kind of thing where there's a low cut and high cut and slight low mid cut. Then a reverb of course to spread that whole tremolo thing, and on the other channel, yeah, there's a low cut on this guitar, and then I'll go back to bus. So there's a low cut over here in this guitar which comes in. See where it comes. It's on the cross. Then we have other guitar. This guitar has little high frequency increase and a very little cut around 20. That's all. Maybe just to phase shift the guitar, I would have done that cut. Then on the next layer, there's a high cut in the start, because start, I was, you know, thinking to keep the guitar softer. and then all the guitars are coming to one bus. Now let me just show you what's happening in the guitar bus. On overall guitar bus, there's a low cut till 68, and then I've added exciter plugin. It's by, I think, VSL. Yeah, VSL exciter. So there's a slight excite color happening around 5K, which is color is 91%. There's drive saturation of that higher end which I'm adding, and the amount, how much to drive and how much amount I want to, you know, add the saturation in that particular area. Then one of my favorite plugin again, BX. There's nothing much going on here. Again, there's a low cut in both the mid and side section, and there's minus 0.8 decibels of volume compensation, and 109 just to clear off center for me, you know, to make the vocal and groove fit in, and just to increase slight brightness in the sides, not in the mid region. Now in the same on the guitar track, what is happening over here? There's a threshold of 13 decibels, ratio 2:1 ratio, attack of 71 ms, and release, it's a very slow release, 980. This is sidechained to kick. So what is happening? Whenever the kick hits, the guitar ducks in. So that what happens whenever the lower end is coming in, it has space to breathe, to leave the sustain, because on the overall master, you know, I felt like the kick should breathe more, it should have more sustain, because bass has a very nice notes going on. Once you listen to the song, you'll understand what I'm talking about. Musically, it's a very rich song. I really like it. It's very nice. Then I have one more compression going on, which is maybe just compressing somewhere, controlling some volume somewhere. So this is after sidechain of the kick, maybe some more frequencies were popping, or maybe some volume was still popping. So it's controlled with very high, you know, ratio 16:0:1. The more higher ratio we shift, the compressor starts reacting like a limiter, you know, because we are tightening up the main place, and it has very less attack because I want the peaks to be heard and the sustain to get compressed. Just hear this. If I bypass everything, there's a fight going on. So there's a fight going. If I turn on the bass guitar, you'll understand. If I turn on everything and play, so there's a ducking happening. Whenever the kick hits in, the guitar goes inside and then it comes back. This is done to fit the bottom end, to make it very clean. If I turn on everything and bypass the guitar processing, just listen to it. So you saw what started happening, bass guitar, kick, the lower end of the reverbs, everything started fighting with each other and it's sounding clumsy. And if I turn on, So the notes of bass is heard very nicely. Kick has a very beautiful sustain. That sustain is not eaten by the lower end sustain of guitars, because there's a space happening because of sidechain, because there's a duck happening over there. Now I'll come back to the next instrument. It's veena. Now I'll show you how the veena was processed. It's recorded very well, definitely. Gopi Sundar, he takes care a lot to record. So basically, I think veena is the processed veena which they sent me. Yes, the reverb is with the veena. So I cleaned up lows, cleaned up little low mids, and cleaned up the mid area so that the guitar licks are heard. And the if I bypass this, it will sound clumsy. So again, same thing as I told you in the last video, I keep telling in all the videos, small tweaks ends up making it very large. As you can see over here, I added a lot of EQs, cuts, increase, you know, dips, added reverb and whatnot. But when I kept listening to it again and again, I felt like, no, this is not working. This is not working. I'll have to work on overall sound rather than, you know, going deep inside and tweaking each and every instrument. See, everything is just bypassed. I'll show you all these things I did in the mix, and I just bypassed everything because this was not working with the song. One by one, you know, when I kept listening to it. Game is happening over here on the bus processing. Since we have guitars and groove as a main instrument, I was not thinking to change the balance of the guitar internally, because, you know, there's chord happening, there's melody happening, and there are some ARP kind of thing going on in the guitars. Then wanted to change the balance of that up, so I did overall bus processing to control it to fight with other instruments. Then I'll come back to vocal and I'll show you the reverbs, what reverb is basically doing. I'll first turn on the chorus over here. Now if I bypass all the reverbs, so it's giving us space. Even for the vocals also, if I'll just turn on the vocals, play you everything, and turn off the reverb entirely. So all the time actually I spent here in editing the reverbs and deciding the decay, sustain time, what kind of reverb should be used to, you know, it should not disturb the kick, snare, bass and guitars, because we have very less element, and yet the reverb has to sound a lot, but still it has to fit in with the track, and it should not sound out of the track. And I kept the groove more up because that was driving the song. I got basically free hand in the mix for this song to decide everything while the mix was going on. You know, you can change the perspective of the mix. So I tried a lot of different perspective, and I ended up mixing this like this way, because for me this was going. So what I did, I worked on what stuff I did on Reverb. Just I'll show you. First, I'll show you what's happening in the voice processing. So we have chorus, one female chorus. So there's male backing, there's female backing, and there's a backing layer of Sid also. So basically what was done here in the female backing vocal, again same thing locally. I think they would have done some processing because it was too clean, everything was very clean, and I had to put the entire track in a perspective. So I am making this video today to tell you guys that even if you get like kind of a very, you know, well balanced stem where the tones are nicely taken and everything is done very nicely, still how can you change the song through different perspective altogether? Like, you know, you can take a song from pop to filmy, like I told you in the last video. So here the same thing, it's a movie song, it had to sound large, big, yet the whole track is in a very pop space. So, you know, there has to be a balance between both the cultures, indie pop thing and the sound of film. So that's how we can get something in a very modern space, you know. I'll show you what's happening in the chorus first. We have female. There's a low cleanup. There's a cleanup around 315 at around 3 decibels. There's a fat EQ going on, in which there's a cut of half decibels and 11k, around 12k, 1 decibel of up. And in the male chorus as well, there's a cut of low till 100, and there's a low mid cleanup around 375, around 6.5 decibels. Now, that sizzle in the chorus is coming because of reverb. Now these two backing vocal, they are going to another all voice bus, and I've got a plugin called Soodi. It's a Soodi, Sood, I don't know. What? How do you spell it nicely? But yeah, I like this plugin. It's useful, takes a lot of processing power, but yeah, it's nice. It's a kind of multi-band thing, which is doing compression but in a very free way. You don't have fixed band for this, so I'll play and you can see. You can decide the depth if you want it more or less. Where you want to cut it more. It's very transparent, very clean plugin. There are a lot of other things also in this, so once you use it, you'll understand. So what it is doing is basically it's doing a compression around low mid 1k, 3-4k. This is basically the sharpness. You can increase to, you know, I'll just show. So the more you increase, it will give you a comb filter kind of feel. So that we should always try to avoid. Then in all vocal bus, there's a low mid cleanup, again mid cleanup, and there's a high mid around 2.3k, that, you know, just below whistle frequency. There's a cut of 1.5 decibels, and there is EOSIS DSR. This is also my favorite actually. So what it is doing, it is just you know, compressing basically the higher end, de-essing the higher end only on the center region.
In came kavale chale idi chale.
It'll not do anything to the stereo source because all the vocals are coming on this bus. My solo vocal and chorus is also coming over here. So I did overall processing after the internal processing is done. So this is just holding around 2 to, you know, 1.5 to 6K or around 10K. It's de-essing those areas. And there's a very little, maybe half decibel of high frequency increased. I will come to the vocal processing. Now, on the voice channel, I've divided this into two different sections. One section is where the entire mukhda happens, and maybe the low portions or high portions happens. So these are two different division, because I had to put different EQs, different processing for both the voices. So if I bypass, let me just turn on and show what I used. So first I cleaned up the low mid, very little, just 1.5 decibels, little low clean. This gain maybe I would have added later on after the bus processing, maybe uska compression kam chahiye tha, you know, to do less compression. I would have added minus 0.8. There's another cut going on, 2.5, minus 4 decibels. His highs increase 5.4, 1.5 decibels. There's a multi band going on.
In came kavale chale idi chale.
It's maybe some preset. I just loaded, it was sounding nice, some small changes in attack, release time and all that. You have all these settings over here. You know, I would have changed, don't remember, it's been quite long. So there's multiband happening over here.
In came kavale.
It's compressing low mid, mid, high mid area and highs area.
In came kavale.
Then there's a very hard compression going on.
In came kavale chale idi chale.
With very less ratio, because overall signal, to compress the overall signal, not to leave any frequencies in that. Then since I cut lot of, you know, mids over here, I meant to say low mid over here and over here. So to get that back again after the multiband compression, because it was controlled, the low mid was controlled and the highs got controlled, I increased around 200 for 1.5 decibels. And since the highs also got controlled, I increased 3 decibels of high frequency. And there's a slight high mid cut around, 3.3 of half decibels.
In came kavale chale idi chale.
It sounds muddy right
now.
Became bright. Now there's another compression going on after that to control.
In came kavale chale. In came kavale chale.
Maybe some, you know, loud portion to control the loud portion. Same thing, I made the compressor act like a limiter with mid 35 millisecond of attack and with a very high ratio. So just to hold one or two words which was going loud in the mix. Then there's a DS happening.
In came kavale chale idi chale.
Very little DS, just to control extra sibilance which was popping out in the mix.
In came kavale chale idi.
And then there's a gain up for 2.3 decibels with the track that I would have thought ki the processing is correct right now. Now we just need to play with the volume. So always a lot of time we get confused between the volume thing and the processing thing. Sometimes, you know, the volume is less and we think, oh, we need to process this more to get this thing out. We need to put more plugin. Don't fall into that thing. Check the volume as well. Make the vocal sit in the track, and then you try to do the EQs and everything. So then you'll have to do less processing and it'll sound more better. This is the first thing. And then now if we come back in the cross. So I think similar thing, there's a cut in lows and low mid, and I added a
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే
మల్టీ బ్యాండ్ బికాస్ ఎక్స్ట్రా లో మిడ్స్ పాపింగ్ అవుట్
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే
ఇట్స్ లిటిల్ బూమీ
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే
వెరీ లిటిల్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వెరీ లిటిల్ లైక్ సాల్ట్ ఆర్ షుగర్ బికాస్ వీఆర్ ట్రయింగ్ టు మేక్ అ డిష్ ఓవర్ హియర్ వీఆర్ నాట్ ట్రయింగ్ టు మేక్ అ డిష్ ఆఫ్ షుగర్ వీఆర్ యాడింగ్ షుగర్ అండ్ సాల్ట్ ఇన్ అ డిష్ You know, whatever we are trying to make, I'll just keep giving you these kind of funny examples. So there is again same thing, low mid cut going on over here, and added one extra SSL channel of waves. There's a low cut till 109, more highs, you know, 14 kk, around almost a decibel highs up, and there's a gate overall here. That's all, that much is happening in this plugin. Then there's a fat EQ, different EQ altogether than compared to the first one I played. Here there's extra low cut because maybe this line had a lot of boominess than these lines. So extra lows are cut over here. There's a slight 1k cut and, you know, highs boost till 2k to make it more bright. Now again there's a compression going on.
Kundalona vegam penchave.
Very tight compression again, long release time. It's holding till the sustain ends. Now this is Harrison, UAD's Harrison 32C SE EQ. Does good, it's pretty bright character EQ. There is around 16k pe 1.5 to 2 decibel highs increase. And there's a low cut going on. Why this low cut? Because I was cutting lows in different after adding compression and or pre-compression. So since it shifts the phase, so maybe to get back the phase again to the original, I do that sometime. I just check it whether where it is sounding good, which placement it is sounding good in the track.
Kundalona vegam penchave. గుమ్మం లోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే
డియర్ సార్
ఊహలకు దొరకని
సొగసా సమ్వేర్ యా దెన్ అగైన్ సేమ్ థింగ్ హార్డ్ కంప్రెషన్ ఫర్ సమ్ వర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ద సాంగ్
ఊహలకు దొరకని సొగస్
and again compensation of 1.5 decibels. So basically this is happening in the vocal and all that mellow sound is because of this particular processing. And yes, there's one more thing going on. There's a parallel compression going on, I believe, on the voice channel of this. Let me just solo it and where it is.
Gundellona vegam penchave.
Yes.
Gummoki holi penchave.
जिंदगी निकाल दिया मैंने इसका इतना ज़्यादा पैरेलल कंप्रेशन किया सी सो द सिग्नल दैट पर्टिकुलर मेन चैनल सिग्नल इज कमिंग टू दिस बस विच इज बेसिकली लाइक दिस
कुंडलोना वेगम पेंचावे
एंड आई जस्ट क्रश इट आई किल्ड इट लाइक दबा दिया मैंने उसको
कुंडलोना वेगम पेंचावे గుమ్మంలోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే
దిస్ ఇస్ టు గివ్ ఎనర్జీ ఇన్ ద వాయిస్
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే
ఐల్ జస్ట్ మ్యూట్ దిస్ అండ్ ప్లే
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే గుమ్మంలోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే నువ్వు పక్కనుంటే ఇంతేనేమోనే
అండ్ టర్న్ ఆన్ అండ్ ప్లే
కుండల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే గుమ్మంలోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే.
కెన్ యూ లిసన్ టు దట్ లిటిల్ గ్రంజ్ హ్యాపనింగ్ ఇన్ ద వాయిస్? ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ జస్ట్ లిటిల్ లిటిల్ ఓన్లీ, అగైన్ లిటిల్ లిటిల్ ఓన్లీ. ఓకే, సో లెట్ మీ కమ్ టు రివర్బ్ ఓవర్ హియర్. What reverbs I've used? Bus number 27. Let's check what is happening in bus number 27. I'll just solo the vocal over here and explain you the reverbs.
In came kavale chale.
So bus number 27, there's a valhalla reverb going on with no pre-delay at all to have that dilute or mixed feel, you know, the main signal, to get to reduce the main signal basically. If I increase the pre delay, you will listen to the main signal also very more clear. See,
in came kavale chale idi chale,
just to make it slightly buttery sound. Terminology. So there's 5.22 second reverb going on. There's a high cut over here. There's depth is 48% and blah blah blah. A lot of things are there, you can see over here. These are the setting for the valhalla. And
in came kavale chale idi chale. నీకై నువ్వే వచ్చి వాళ్ళవేపై తిరనాళ్ళే.
అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఓన్లీ రివర్బ్ అట్ దిస్ సెక్షన్.
ఇంకేం కావాలే చాలే ఇది చాలే, నీకై నువ్వే వచ్చి వాళ్ళవే ఇకపై తిరనాళ్ళే. గుండెల్లోన వేగం పెంచావే, లోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే.
So since I cut lot of low mid in this second section, so I added another reverb over here, which is just like ambience.
గుండెల్లో నా వేగం పెంచావే, గుమ్మంలోకి హోలీ తెచ్చావే.
It's like a thick source of reverb, not as thin as the way is this one. See, different character altogether. So basically, if I mute this reverb and the parallel processing, so you can see everything is dry in the song. Veena is dry, groove is dry, guitars are dry. I didn't add any reverb to it, but still it will give you that feeling of massive reverb.
Dellona vegam penchave, gummamloki holi tachave, nuvvu pakkanunte intenemone. Inke minke kavale chale idi chale, nike nuvve vachi valave.
You can see some very beautiful bass line is going on. So what I have done in bass, same thing. See, I just left the dynamics of bass. I just left it. I didn't kill it. I didn't compress it. You can see the volume is less, and then it goes very high. It goes too high, and then it again drops in. So it keeps getting louder and softer. So I've not killed the dynamics of the song. You can see the guitar is soft here, and then it goes in the louder portion. If I compress, I can compress it and get it to similar volume. This song needs more dynamics and less compression basically internally. I compressed it on the master. I'll show you that one. So in bass, same thing is going on. I have one very small, I would have done one EQ, but again I cut it. So it's not about just doing it. You main thing is you have to understand that whatever you have done, you should be ready enough to you should be mature enough to bypass it when it is not sounding good. And this whole calculation, you got to do it by yourself first and then send it to someone else to listen to the mix. So you can see again there is a sidechain compression going on, sidechain kick. If I solo the bass,
okay.
it's only come doing the compression on the place where the kick is coming in. Now all together, as you saw, okay, there's very less, very few EQs were done, but I'll bypass the master because that was done according to that balance and that particular EQ, but you see the difference. So how can these small things on chorus again? EOS 1 previous version reverb is going on 4.67 second of reverb, and there's some delays also going on at some places which is automated in the vocals. If I show you the voice channel, so there's alap going on at some places. So it's a filtered high filter and low filter, and some mid cut to make it more softer and warmer, and there's again another low cut going on, and there's a compression going on so very hard compression going on. Just maybe to make it, you know, thick and glue it in the track. Now let me come to the master section and I'll show you what I have done on the master. So the first thing first, I added one UAD precision multiband. Basically there's nothing going on in this plugin. I just added this to get a bright character. This multiband compression has a very brighter character to it. So if I bypass this, you just listen to this. I'll bypass it while playing. Just to get that slight little brighter feel. Then second thing, BX EQ. Why did I use this BX EQ? V2 to control the center. So now there's a cut around 226 in the center signal, not in the stereo side, not on this S side, on the M side. And there's another cut going on at 724 of 0.3 decibels, and there's a DS also going on. At 3.51, just to control extra high mids, popping high mids. So what happened because of this, the track became more wider. The lows are not breathing, that low is, it's not happening. When I turn on, everything sits properly. Everything is sounding muddy and boxy. If I bypass that, then there's another cut around 290 for 1 decibels and 1.6 of half decibels, which is. So see how every time I'm turning on 1-1 EQ and the sound is going towards more pop side, you know, that whole round muddy thing is just getting out of the place, and you know, it's gaining more brighter and popish approach of the overall sound. Mm-hmm. there's a compression going on which is just controlling the kick and the bass area. Since I did a you know, I used a sidechain in almost guitars, vocals and all the on other elements, so the kick became solo and it was moving a lot. So just to compress the kick, there's a high ratio time and attack is slow, and a little bass guitar as well because I didn't use the compression on the channel.
ಮಮ್ಲೋಕಿ ಹೋಲಿ ತಚ್ಚವೇ ನುವ್ವು ಪಕ್ಕ ನುಂಟೇ ಇಂತೇನೇಮೋನೇ ನಾಕೊಕ್ಕೋ ಗಂಟ ಒಕ್ಕೋ ಜನ್ಮೆ.
And there's a gain compensation going off 2.5 decibels because there's a compression going off 2.5 decibels.
ಮಮ್ಲೋಕಿ ಹೋಲಿ ತಚ್ಚವೇ ನುವ್ವು ಪಕ್ಕ.
Then there's another compressor again, stock, DAW.
ಮಮ್ಲೋಕಿ ಹೋಲಿ ತಚ್ಚವೇ ನುವ್ವು ಪಕ್ಕ ನುಂಟೇ ಇಂತೇನೇಮೋ.
Medium attack time, very 1.6, you know, compression ratio, overall compression tight one. And then okay, this I would have put after the limiter, after I applied the limiter to maybe reduce 0.3 decibel input of that. And this much of compression is going on or limit is going on in the limiter. Now see how you can really, actually, if I bypass everything over here, leaving the gain, see, reverbs and everything vanished. Now you see. So basically guys, this was very small short video I thought to make on Inkem Inkem song. Go and listen to it. Lovely song by Gopi Sundar and his team, and I got my hands on to mix this song, and I played you the version which I received, and I played you the version which I mixed. So you saw how these small, again I'm saying small because I do vast and weird one also, but for me all these are small tweaks, and how these small tweaks controls the entire track, and then in end when you master a track, it shapes up on a larger scale. So again, don't get scared of doing experiments. Keep doing experiments. Remove it, put it back, again mix it, again do, again put it back, change the reverb, change the setting, change the kick processing. Don't want to process, don't process. See how sometime the magic just lies in one point. Maybe you just get one point and the entire song just gets locked. It just goes and sits in the pocket. It's just about finding the pocket. Again, same thing, keep listening to a lot of music because you will get perspective in the brain. When you listen to the song, you'll understand which way to go in. That's all. Take care guys. Be happy, love each other, love everybody, and keep sharing. I'll keep opening songs like this. This is very beautiful song. Again, I'm saying go through the entire album. It has got a couple of more tracks, and all the tracks are very nice actually. And again, thanks to Abhishek who was there with me to, you know, basically chop everything. And till now I opened the tracks, the songs which had lots and lots of track. So a lot of people asked me ki, you know, what will happen if I have very less tracks happening in the song. So that's why I opened this song, and I wanted to show you guys that less is also more. Less is actually always more. So how in the less elements also, how in clean elements also, you can basically make your track larger and bigger. So take care. ఇది మీరు చూడండి, తెలుగులో మాట్లాడుతున్నాను ఎందుకంటే ఇది తెలుగు పాట. మీరు కూడా షేర్ చేయండి, అందరినీ పంపించండి మీ మ్యూజిషియన్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ని, అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి ఇన్ ది సాంగ్, ఆల్ ద మ్యూజిషియన్స్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి, దే ఆర్ అమేజింగ్, అండ్ సెడ్ తో ఆల్వేస్ nails it, man. So I get to mix a lot of song of which Sid sings. So I'll come back and see you again next time. This is made in lot of chaos, at very odd hours again. So take care guys, see you sound family, अच्छे से रहो और हम लोग फिर मिलते हैं.